All right, welcome to Gratitude and Alchemy. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Joe Rare, and if you've never watched one of these episodes before, welcome. If you have, welcome back. This is where we share really some things to be grateful for, some things that I'm grateful for today, and then how they produce results in life. That's the alchemy side of things. And what I'm gonna challenge you to do is actually come up with something that you're holding gratitude for today. Even if you're in a bad spot, if things aren't going the way that you want them to, share something in the comments of really what you can focus on really to be grateful for. Because as we all know, energy flows where attention goes. So what we give our attention to is going to expand, right? And so we're gonna have more of it. And without getting too, you know, ethereal or esoteric or whatever you wanna call it, you know, I wanna be very practical about things. Like, it's just a fact that what you focus on is what you see. And so when it comes to gratitude, you know, what we do know is that you cannot be unhappy and grateful at the same time. It's not possible. You can't be angry and grateful at the same time. You can hold one feeling, one emotional kind of stance at one time. And so if you choose to be grateful about something, everything else gets set aside. Now, of course, you can go back to it, but the goal would be that you focus on the gratitude. So where I want to start today is I want to talk to you really quick about something that I'm super grateful for. Somebody basically just gave me some of their time today. And I know that might seem a little kind of simple, but the truth is in the last episode, I talked about going to a business conference for marketing and things like that. The community as a whole being absolutely unbelievable. It's a beautiful community, a lot of amazing people. And one person that I had met sort of through the community, kind of weird how it ended up happening, but we ended up not getting to spend any time together like we had planned. So we finally reconnected just a few days ago, and she is a dog trainer. Actually a very amazing dog trainer at that. And today she gave me an hour of her time. We did a Zoom video chat. And today, obviously, I'm working from home. And so we spent some time chatting and talking about, you know, our 8-month-old golden retriever that we have and how we want to train him and what we want as the outcome. We want this dog that is just unbelievably obedient. He's well-trained. You know, he comes when he's called from any distance, with any amount of distractions. You know, we, you know, create some good habits at home and make it easy so that my children can, you know, he'll mind my children and things like that. And so there's a lot to it. And, you know, some of it, we started off kind of on the wrong foot with a few things. You know, some of it I'll kind of place some blame in the household, my kids feeding the dog, you know, our food and all kinds of stuff like that. My wife lets him up on the couch sometimes. And so he's created a nice little habit with that. But anyhow, just, you know, some of those little things that we want to attempt to condition so that what we want is him to obey. He can do things when we invite him to, but not whenever he feels like it. And I got some amazing tips and you know, strategies and things that we can do from spending some time with somebody who charges for her time, but she gave her time to me. And I'm extremely grateful for her sharing that time because I think it's a lot. It goes to show how much she loves what she does. And of course she has a loyal following. She has a lot of really great clients. And she's created a course. And so I purchased the course and we are going to be going through the course kind of as a family and learning these, how we teach the dog and train the dog. And I'm just super grateful for the opportunity to work with her and for the time that she spent. And so the alchemy side of it, what has transmutated already, like what transformed or come out of this is that already, and I'm looking over here because that's where the dog is, already I've been able to actually implement some of the things she's just told me about and actually seeing a response and a result out of the dog. So super grateful for that. I appreciate her time. And if anybody's interested, I can shoot you a DM because she's absolutely unbelievable. So share with me, what are you grateful for? What's going on in your life that you can say, hey, this is what I am grateful for, and I want to express it out loud. Because remember, the louder we can get about positivity, positive things, the more it's going to drown out a lot of the negativity. There's plenty of negative shit if you want to go look at it. It's everywhere. You log on to Facebook, log on to Twitter, log on to anything, and you can see more negativity than you've ever seen in your whole life. So if you want to shift that, Let's get loud about positivity, about having gratitude, being grateful for things. Let's really put our focus there. So share with me in the comments, what are you grateful for? If you know somebody who needs to maybe shift into a different mindset, maybe share this video with them, tag them in the comments, do something to help other people, because I think that, you know, gratitude is really going to be the voice of humanity. It's the way that we are going to be able to change the world in our own little way. And it starts internally with us. So choose to be grateful, because remember, gratitude is really the way to happiness. You cannot be upset and grateful at the same time. It's not possible. So every day, just remember, be fucking grateful. Have a great day.